In this video, I am going to discuss further regarding the divisions of polynomials. So here I am going to use the formula in order to divide a polynomial by another polynomial. So let's see how the approach of the formula of dividing the polynomial is coming here. So take a look at this example. We are going to divide 2x cubed plus 4x square plus 6 minus 6. 2x cubed plus 4x square plus 6 minus 6 by x plus 4. So we will see what is the formula. The formula for division will be, if you have a set of functions as fx, which will be the divisor, which is the polynomial that they have given to divide, and then gx be the divider. That's going to be the divider that we are going to divide the given polynomial. And then hx will be the quotient. Quotient means the result, answer. When you divide the polynomial by divider, you are getting the quotient that will be referred to hx. And if you get a remainder at last, that will be considered as Rx. So the formula will be fx equal gx into hx plus Rx. The divisor equal divider multiplied by quotient plus remainder. So the main important thing here will be, we don't know what is the quotient and what is the remainder coming. So what we do? We write down by using some arbitrary constant values, by using constant terms, a general format of the quotient and the remainder. Actually, that can be expressed by considering the given polynomial and the divider order. So how do we decide the order? This is how you can decide it. The order of the quotient will be the difference of the orders in between the polynomial and the divider. That means whatever the polynomial you have, take that order minus order of the divider that you are going to divide. For an example, if you have a polynomial with order 5, you are going to divide it by polynomial of order 1, 5 minus 1. So order will be 4. So you have to write a general expression by using some arbitrary constants to express the quotient with order 4. Then the remainder will be definitely, the order will be 1 less than the divider. So if you have a divider with order 1, then the remainder order will be 1 minus 1, which is 0. 0 means a constant value. So here fx is equal to 2x cubed plus 4x square plus 6 minus 6. That's going to be the fx. Then our order of this polynomial is how much? 2x cubed, the highest power is 3, therefore order will be 3. Gx, that's going to be x plus 4, x to the power 1, that means order 1. Now we will see what should be the order of the polynomial or the quotient. The quotient that we are getting in this question. So order of the polynomial divisor is 3. Order of the divider is 1. Then order of the quotient will be 3 minus 1, which means our quotient will be a general expression of quadratic form, because order is 2. Order 2 means x squared term will be the highest power. So I can write it as ax square plus bx plus c. Here x square term is there, x term is there, and abc values are going to be constant terms which you need to find in the question. Then we will attend to the remainder. Order of the divider is 1, then order of the remainder should be 1 minus 1, which is 0. That means you can write it as capital D, a constant value. So remainder will be capital D. Now we will form, or we will apply these results to the formula of dividing a polynomial. Then the format or the order of the formula is fx equal gx into hx plus rx. So let's see how it is coming. So fx will be 2x cube plus 4x square plus x minus 6. So I replace it by that. Then gx will be 4, as I don't remember. Let's see. So fx equal gx into hx plus rx. So fx is 2x cube plus 4x square plus 6 minus 6 equals gx, which is x plus 4. Then the quotient, we wrote it in a general format, ax square plus bf plus c. That's also k, then outside the bracket, plus rx. That will be capital D. Now we have to find the values of a, b, c and d. Then actually there are two basic methods to find out the constant values a, b, c, d. One method will be we can consider the similar type of terms. That means we are going to equate the coefficients of corresponding terms in either side. For an example, if you have x cube in left hand side, x cube term coming in the right hand side, equating the coefficients of them. Otherwise we can substitute a value for x, then simplify and get the result for the unknown constant terms. Sometimes you may have to build up some equations, then by solving them simultaneously, you will be able to find out the values of A, B, C and D. Let's see here what is the most suitable method here. Actually sometimes we use both the methods, not only a single method. So here I'm going to compare similar terms in either side. By comparing the coefficients of x cube terms, left hand side you have what? So if I consider the coefficients of x cube terms in either side, left hand side you had plus 2x cube, so coefficient will be plus 2. In the right hand side you are getting x into ax squared. X into x squared becomes a into x to the power cube. So a will be the coefficient there. So then a is equal to plus 2. Simply you can find it. Then I am going to consider the coefficients of x squared terms in either side. Let's see what are the terms which is having x square terms in either side. Left hand side 4x square, which is plus 4, will be the coefficient. Right hand side, if I focus, I can get two possibilities, ax square into 4 and x into bx. X into bx becomes bx squared, and 4 into x square becomes 4ax squared. So x into bx, b will be the coefficient, 4 into a, 4a will be the coefficient. So 4a plus b, or b plus 4a. So 4a plus b, but we have found the values of capital A earlier, which is plus 2. Therefore 4 equal 8 plus b. Then we can find the value of capital B quite easily. So 4 minus 8 will be minus 4. Therefore we have found the value of constant B as negative 4. Now let's see how we can find the remaining terms which are the values of capital C and capital D. So there I'm going to use the method of substitution. If I use the method of substitution by looking at the equation we have, we will be able to find out the constant capital D. How do I decide that? First look at the product of gx and hx. In gx you can see clearly that if I substitute x equal minus 4, then what will happen? Minus 4 plus 4 becomes 0. So 0 into that expression becomes 0. So a, b, c terms are not coming there. Only remaining term will be capital D. But left hand side you have to substitute the value minus 4 to each and every term. Then 2 multiplied by minus 4 to the power 3 or negative 4 to the power 3. Then we have plus 4x squared. So plus 4 multiplied by minus 4 squared. Plus 4 multiplied by minus 4x squared. Then if I go to the next term that we have, the third term, that will be plus 12x, as I remember, so it will be plus x. So plus x means plus minus 4. Then finally we have negative 6 as well, equal to, you remember the first two brackets become 0, therefore 0 plus d. If I simplify this expression in left hand side, I can find the value of capital D. So minus 4 to the power 3 become minus 64, minus 64 into 2 become minus 128, then minus 4 square into 4 becomes 64, so minus 28 plus 64, then minus 4 minus 6 becomes minus 10. Then finally we can get the value of capital D as negative 74. So let's see. So capital D will be negative 74. So we have found the values of A, B and then D. But we have to find the value of capital C as well. Now I am going to equate the coefficient of terms, but the remaining term will be constant term. So we are going to equalize the constant terms in either side. So left hand side we have minus 6. Right hand side 4 into C. 4 into C becomes 4C. In addition to that, outside we have capital D. So 4C plus D. So then negative 6 is equal to 4C plus D. We found the value of capital D as negative 74. Therefore 4C is equal to 74 minus 6, which will be 68. Then C is equal to 68 divided by 4. So C will be equal to plus 17. Now we are done with finding the values of A, B, C, D. Then we can go to our general expressions that we formed at the beginning for the quotient and the remainder. Then we can write down the quotient as AX square plus BX plus C. A becomes plus 2 then we found B is equal to negative 4 and then A equal to B equal negative 4. Then at last we found C is equal to 17. capital C is equal to 17. Therefore, the final result 2x squared b becomes negative 4, therefore minus 4x. Then finally, c becomes 17 plus 17. So, we are done with finding the quotient by applying the formula method. Find the remainder, that is just negative 74, we just found it. So, d value is negative 74. So, finally, remainder becomes negative 74. So, this is how you are going to apply the formula in order to divide a given polynomial by another polynomial. So, I believe both methods are fine for the moment. In order to divide a given polynomial by another polynomial, what are the two main methods? Long division process and by using the formula method. So, this video will be ended from here. In the next video, I am going to discuss the remaining part of this lesson, polynomials. We have a lot more to discuss, so then hope you will be there for the